tuning in to Saving Throw. I mean, this has been a great stream. We've already hit our goal, but we can still do better. I'm gonna be your host for the night, GM Mace. Let's go around the table. Let's introduce everybody.
Yay.
Ben, let's start with you.
Hi, I'm Ben.
Hi, Ben.
Hey, I'm Amy Vorpal, otherwise known as Vorpal Sword.
Erica.
Hi, I'm Erica Ishii.
I'm Sean Graham.
And I'm David Crennan.
Now, unlike other D&D streams, you can actually affect what happens in this. You guys can donate money to have more bad guys show up, more good guys, give them rerolls, whatever you so choose. This is unlike our normal Barkeys Brigade. If you're familiar with that, you know, come on down. It's great stuff. It's a little different. New characters. We do have one recurring character, though, and that is Garthok. Ben, why don't you tell us a little bit about your character, please, and thank you.
Well, I'm playing Garthok the Drunken. This one? Hey, I'm Garthok the Drunken. If you follow Saving Throw, that's one of our original characters, my original character. I am a dwarf fighter, now a level 12 dwarf fighter.
Hey! Ooh.
And because of certain donation aspects that we've had, he's a little different. For one, he went on from his adventures that you last saw him, he went on to be a sailor, thanks to one Sean Graham. A donation made by Sean Graham.
I actually, if I remember correctly, that was a Mrs. Hungerham that donated.
Oh, yes. Sorry. Yeah. Mrs. Hungerham.
Mrs. Yeah. Ham.
Mrs. Yeah. Ham.
And then also thanks to Mark, I'm going to mispronounce your name, Mark.
Ms. Bacara.
Ms. Bacara. Ms. Bacara.
What is that? Is it Patino or is it...
Patno?
I think it's Patno.
Right. Mark also donated to me, but he didn't specify what he wanted from my list.
You can just do
so
whatever you want.
Do
yeah, yeah. Mark's just awesome.
Well, I have Garthok has a catchphrase now, and it's for the garbage people.
Ooh.
Yes.
Yay. Yes.
Awesome. That is amazing.
So we'll see how Garthok does.
Amy, what are you playing today?
Okay, I'm playing Linnea Trumbull, and she is a forest gnome warlock, and she's got a little sprite named Tam, and that's how she communicates with her demon, or sorry, Taz. And she is, because of Mark Patinode, or Bisbecare, is in love with Garthok. Just submit him.
Gross.
And and that was one of the things that I put on my intentions, and I did say I'm going to play the S out of it, so I'm going to play the S out of it.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. Gross.
Yeah. Erica, what are you playing today?
I am playing Penelope Lightfoot. She's a halfling rogue, and in her own hometown, she's just a lovable scamp with a penchant for kleptomania. And because of generous donations, she's starting out with a healing donut, a donut that cures light wounds, and she's easily distracted, so you can donate to have her do really special things. They're on my page. Should we run down some of the,
totally.
Things?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, so for instance, for mine, for $15, this is a reference to my own channel, my character will perform 5 to 8 seconds of the Neon Cat song just randomly, complete with dance. For 20, Candy, character stops whatever she's doing. Whatever she's doing, it doesn't matter if we're in the middle of combat, she eats a handful of candy.
Will that happen in real life?
Because we have candy, then yes.
That's amazing.
Oh, it'll happen.
So for $20, you'll eat candy in real life.
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, that's
and,
a great deal.
30 is hardcore parkour, and she's just gonna stop whatever she's doing and do like a backflip or a wall jump or whatever they tell me to do. And then $50 is to you pick my catchphrase. $60 is a spontaneous alignment change because maybe I just don't feel like being lawful good anymore.
Yeah. Chaotic evil. Yeah.
Lawful good, you say? Lawful good.
Good. It just
very strict code
can
of conduct.
Can I back up real second and go back to me? Just because I didn't do any of the donations.
Yeah, do you
do
your
thing. There's some other stuff on the page that you can look at, but this is the big one.
Yeah.
You can get Stop and Go, and I will give them to you.
What?
I'll mail Stop and Go to you. It is $500 donation, and that's kind of to deter people from actually doing it.
yeah.
But because I don't want to give up my weapons, but...
Those are your bonded dice.
These are my bonded dice. And then you can bond with me, I guess.
They're already attuned to you.
Yeah, you can.
And But like, they're garbage people, so like, hell, they're going to donate $500.
We should point out that, you know, like, as we all know, people on the internet are awful. And then particularly garbage people.
I feel like it was a, an
not going to do that.
It was a clever segue.
Yeah, it was.
Attacking the people.
Hi, I'm Sean Graham. I'm playing a character named Basarero.
Excellent!
That name was chosen for me by someone who donated, and it means like garbage person or garbage collector, I think. I'm not fluent in anything other than English, but
that's debatable.
I like him.
And then my class was also chosen by somebody who donated, and the class that I'm going to be playing today is garbage person. So that's.
So you're one of the people.
I am representing today and only today. I will be representing the garbage people of the internet denizens that we all know are terrible.
Does everyone know what garbage people are?
Almost no one knows what the garbage people are, I think, probably. So every week when people tune in to Saving Throw Show, we have people that tune in and pay attention to us. And the reason they do that probably is because they have nothing going on in their lives.
Oh, boy.
And they just generally, I think it's fair to make the assumption that they're bad people.
Okay.
So in our stream, they are allowed to donate money to give money to the GM or to other players. And sometimes that money is donated to harm me. And again, I defend those donations. It makes a lot of sense because I would also want to harm me because I am awesome. So I get it. Like, yeah, of course you want to donate money to take me down because you're like, oh man, I wish I was more like Sean.
I want to bring you to their level, right?
Yeah. It's like, to make it fair, it's like a handicap.
And today, Ben's fucking chant
is for the garbage people.
Yeah.
Oh, also Ben donated to make me a prostitute. So my character an STD-ridden prostitute.
A lower class STD-ridden prostitute.
And I just want to point out my character, you know, has a past. Like, that's fine. And I don't think we should be ashamed of our sex work. I'm still a sex worker for sure. We should encourage and support all sex workers, in my opinion.
I really should have gone over your guys' characters before we got to
this. Yeah, oh, by the way, sorry I didn't email that to you.
Wow.
Follow that up.
Okie doke. So, hi. Yeah, I'm playing a gnome transmuter. Mm. His name was suggested by the donations as well. Should I be looking up there?
That one.
Look up there. That guy. Hi. So this name was suggested by at SpaceSeeker19. That's SpaceSeeker Harold. Thank you. So my character's name is Kerfuffle Exclamador Waxington Smythe IV. And that is, I guess, how I'm going to talk.
Is Exclamador from the Battle Wizards? Is that Exclamador?
No.
Isn't Exclamador, that's like a part of speech. Like, that's like punctuation, right?
Exclamador!
No, that's like Interrobang.
Oh, okay.
Interrobang.
And that's my brother, is Kerfuffle Interrobang.
Interrobang.
Waxington Smith IV. Yes, so I've got that. I also have a battle cry. This was also donated to me. I have to say, Julia Marchesi is a super vixen!
That sounds true.
Yeah, I would. Very true. I'm rallied now. I feel like fighting something.
I don't know quite how that fits into my character. I also have multiple personality syndrome.
Well, that could be right there.
Yeah.
That comes from Kieran Evitz. Thank you very much, Kieran. That's another donation. And finally, and again, I am a wizard. I have a fetish for oozes and gelatinous cubes. And if I see one, I have to attack it with my bare hands.
When you say fetish.
Yeah, they didn't elaborate on it, really.
Okay.
Well, no, they did. They said I have to. Yeah. Like, I feel compelled to.
So it's like a tangible, love the squishiness. It's like a touching
fetish.
Yeah. Okay. I think I just want to plunge into
it. It's like the, like you want to push a bunch of buttons. You want to submerge your flesh.
I mean, that's not an unusual fetish.
That actually sounds really fun.
Yeah, did they say specifically it had to be with your hands?
Yeah, they said with my bare hands.
Okay.
And gelatinous cubes, as we all know, paralyze on touch. So
yeah,
that's true.
I don't think I'm gonna last forever.
But Jello wrestling in our world is a thing, so I think it's a pretty normal fetish.
Yeah. Acid Jello wrestling. Yeah. We need to get that.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I'd be fine with acid Jello wrestling.
Yeah, Linnea might develop a fetish for watching people attack gelatinous cubes.
Yeah, for sure.
So Kerfuffle, yes, and you can call me Mr. Waxington Smythe IV for short.
For short.
Yeah.
For short.
Something like that.
Okay, I actually forgot. I also need to roll a random phobia that Mark donated for. So I am going to have something that I am afraid of. That's an eight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, this is a bad fear to have.
If Mark is in the chat at all, he can make clear what he would like to donate, what he wants his donation used for, my character.
Okay, I have Iluro-phobia, which I guess this is a good fear to have today. Normally it would be a terrible fear for my character to have. It is a fear of cats. So my
character,
more than one.
There are,
I think it's fair
there
to say.
Are tons of cats. I have a kitty collar of cat holding, and as an attack, I can unleash them.
Yeah.
What?
That doesn't sound like a standard thing.
I think you can find it in every book. Every RPG worth its salt has a kitty collar of cat holding. Yeah, it's very normal.
I mean, I guess if someone donates, we'll say $100, the kitty collar could have come with you.
It could
show up. Yeah, that would paralyze my character.
Yeah.
But you'd have cats, though, so
that's
a trade-off.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I'd trade off cats.
Oh, no. I think you would let me be paralyzed in real life if you were if you could just meet a cat for a minute. Yeah. Like, oh, for sure. Sean's nothing. And also, I would defend that choice because I agree.
You hate yourself.
I mean, come on.
All right. So, all of you guys, people have been taken from across the land. You all have been investigating certain friends, family, villagers, garbage people.
Oh, God. Bless you. I'm so sorry.
Gross.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, yes.
Garbage people, bless you.
Excuse
garbage
me.
People, bless
you.
That was amazing.
So people have gone missing.
Okay.
Somehow you guys have all crossed paths. You guys have been working together to find out where they've gone. You guys have heard whispers of them being taken to this place called the Chamber of Dire Devastation.
Oh.
Fun place, right?
Yeah.
Every lead you followed has come up cold, save for one, which has led you to the doorway of the chamber. Just as you are about to enter the chamber.
Chamber of Dire Desolation?
Devastation.
Dire Devastation.
Oh.
Even worse.
Mm-hmm. Devastating, like dire.
Yeah.
So just as you guys are about to enter, you'd be set by
like
an unseen
desolate.
Enemy. You guys fall victim to it and you awaken in chains.
Crap.
All of your equipment gone.
No, god damn it.
Again.
What?
Welcome to the party.
Oh god.
God damn it.
Naked as well.
Every single time.
No, not naked. You guys still have your clothes.
They took, they took my weapons.
My orb.
Oh, no, my weapons.
Yeah, that's the worst thing. I had a board with a nail in it and a trash can lid for a shield.
Well, you'll never find that again. You'll never find it.
I don't know where you find things like that.
We
oh, God.
Find your board with nail.
Thank you, Garthok.
My friend Basora.
Who could have imagined?
You are so brave. You are just so brave. I want to ask you something.
God, just go away.
Oh, I just want to ask you one thing.
Yes.
Where exactly do we stand?
So what is the...
I don't understand the question.
No, I just want a DTR real quick.
Oh.
Penelope sits down and like tennis matches with her eyes.
Listen, we're just friends.
One thing that I know about being a garbage person and be constantly rejected by the other sex is that you can always work towards perhaps maybe someday being liked by the object of your desire.
I knew there was hope.
There is.
God
there
damn
absolutely
it,
is hope.
Basura.
Basurero. Why can't anyone remember my name or anything important about me? Is it because I'm worthless?
So when we go and find his lid and his board, maybe we can find my orb too with the same fervor, Garthok.
I'm sure we can find it.
With the same fervor, though.
I mean, she's not a garbage person.
Yeah.
Listen, friends, dear friends, garbage person, drunk dwarf,
looks?
All of you who I love and I've been on this quest
shit.
With.
Oh, warlock.
I fear that we're in a dangerous situation. Who could have thought that the Chamber of Dire Devastation may have been dangerous?
Ooh, I don't know, but you sound so joyful about it.
I'm fine.
Okay.
For now. Very, very good. No problems. Everything's fine.
Are you dictating to someone? Sounds like someone should be ready.
Everything's fine as long as we can get my pills back before too long, because otherwise, well, I don't know, but everything's fine. So everything's fine, and it's fine.
Okay.
Can I look around and see what
we detailed?
Sure. Yeah. I get you everyone's minis, please.
What do the pills do?
Oh, let's back up a bit.
Are these like fun pills?
Amy, can you get you mini?
Because you know it's okay. No. If you go for 24 hours without them, you'll be fine. I've been through this. I'm there for you, buddy.
Well, they're my dried frog pills, and I just need to sometimes eat. Just one or two of them, just which is fine, and I'm fine, and everything will be fine.
Bossarero pulls out a wet paper sack from CVS.
Where did you get that?
Where were you hiding it? Don't touch it! Don't touch it!
Okay, I oftentimes scrounge behind CVS. This has pills in it. I'm not sure what they are, but it's probably what you need.
Yes, pills. Okay, very good.
You're welcome.
You got pills.
This will be good. Okay, which is fine, and it's absolutely fine, and I'm sure everything will be perfectly okay.
Well, all of this is going on. I'd like. Are we tied? We're chained.
You guys are chained inside of a cage.
To each other.
To each other.
Shit.
Let me try and get out. Let me.
Can I get
another scenario? Oh, yeah. This is exactly.
Can I get everyone's
what
minis?
Want.
Please throw them over here.
Minis.
Oh yeah.
Everyone, how close to Linnea am I?
You're chained to her, so within 5 feet.
Yes. I play footsie with him, and it turns into legsy. Yeah.
Just full on.
Yeah.
Okay. Not even like sexually, just feet.
My
everywhere.
Little stubby dwarven legs
maybe,
try to kick away.
Maybe not.
I feel like legsy is
people.
Basically just another term for scissoring.
Tripping? Are we tripping?
Indeed. Everyone, give me perception checks. Investigation would also work.
I'll do my investigation then.
Oh.
19.
19.
Oh, this should go in there, shouldn't it? Next time.
Ooh, good roll, Garthok.
20.
Nicely done.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, not well.
Oh, God. Plus 6, 23.
8.
Give me my die. 18 from Bossarero.
Okay, anyone that gets over a 10.
Oh.
All right.
Oh, okay.
Notices that the iron of the bars itself are rusted as if they've been there for a very long time and are making use of it. This may have been an old prison of some kind, and they're just... Oh, this
one on the
to
chain.
Do. The chains look fresh and new iron. The locks on them look.
Can we reach the bars while still chained up?
Yes, the chains are not to the floor. They're, you guys are chained to each other.
Okay.
Can we try and pick the locks?
Sure. Do you have thieves' tools?
Yes. Well, I mean, not with me, I guess.
Exactly.
But I mean, maybe like
I mean,
a hair.
Probably
like,
try and wiggle well, out though.
Maybe like know, maybe a hairpin we, that would have been like stuck behind a ear.
For $5, we can say she has a hairpin. Donate $5 to the Extra Life.
Give
there's
us
a hairpin.
Money.
Well, while that's happening,
for the children.
Am I close enough? How close to the bars am I?
You're about 5 feet away.
Okay.
So these are the bars right here.
Can I easily get to them?
Yes.
I'd like to dwarf kick them.
You dwarf kick them?
I will dwarf kick.
Okay, yeah. You're going to have that at a disadvantage, so go ahead.
Because of the chains.
So you roll 2d20s. Take the lower two.
And what, when you have a chance, what do we see in the room beyond the bars? Oh, still pretty good.
11. So 15.
15? You kick him, and one of the iron bars just falls forward.
Ding!
Uh-oh.
Because that's how the game starts.
Ah!
You see a floating, rotted orb. It looks like it's unaware of you.
Is it my orb?
Yeah.
It is?
It's not.
Well, does your
orb holder?
Yeah, look at the okay, map, do you carry this around with you all the time? Because I have some concerns about your choices in life.
It looks
if you
a
do.
Little more toothy and eye-y than it usually does. Sorry, Linnea.
No, that's okay. I'm a little nearsighted. It is the same shape, though.
Wait.
Now, it is the same shape. No one yell at me about that. Same shape as my orb.
This is why you will forever
be
alone.
Quick concern. You are nearsighted. And you primarily make range attacks. Is that correct?
Just
checking. Someone took her glasses, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm sure this is going to be fine.
I can fix that. I can try.
Your finish with me makes sense now.
Yeah. Short-sighted.
So, looking around the room, you see that orb. Dotting the walls or torches, you are unable to see the roof. It goes far up into the darkness, so it's at least 40 feet high.
I can see the roof!
No, you can't.
No, you can just see darkness.
Okay.
Over here is a chest.
So that's, like, is it just watching us, like, guarding us, basically?
Oh, God, you guys!
Sitting there like a sentry mode.
Somebody, I need candy! Bring now! I'm sorry! I'm
Red,
so sorry. Just I know candy. That we got something.
From Sean's garbage bag comes out candy.
Oh god.
Penelope just sits down and from literally nowhere grabs a handful of candy and stuffs it in her face.
Yeah, you do it to the camera. Do it to the camera.
Wow.
She did that. Show.
She did that.
That's great.
Well.
How far well are we going?
Well, okay, very good. I think we're fine.
Where did that come from?
You don't want to know.
No, I really don't. Yeah, no, actually, I shouldn't have even asked.
No.
But would you like some?
No.
Not now, no. Ever, actually. Let me clarify. No. Never. Never do I want candy. Mm. If somebody donates $20, then I will eat some candy out of another person's mouth.
For 20?
Hold on.
It's official. That's happening.
Oh, my God.
I said that out loud, and I realized that I feel like it should have been more than
$20.
Yeah. $20 is very
We've got two donation pages open at the table for you, buddy.
Oh, boy. You didn't donate.
I didn't.
Okay, thank you. Okay. I appreciate that. Surely Let's just move on. What's going on with this beholder?
Right. I think perhaps we can reason with it.
Okay. It's a bunch of eyes and teeth.
Garthok's always right.
They're very good, I agree. Here we are. All right.
So far.
So you call to it.
In a friendly way. Okay.
I guess so. That seems like a good idea to me. So I kind of try and stand up, but I'm a gnome, so the chains pull me down. Assuming I'm still wearing my clothes, which we established I am. Mm-hmm. So I'm like the equivalent of a 45-year-old man, but as a gnome, so it'd be like 200 and something. Okay, got a bit of a paunch. Dresses in, got like a green silk shirt. Black. Floppy hair that kind of like flops down and he gets it out of his way.
Just like kind of things from Gringotts?
a little younger than that. Like a young guy from Gringotts. The new guy, the male guy.
yes. The rookie banker.
Hello!
Jeez. The orb turns towards you.
It wasn't looking at us?
Eye opens.
I thought it was looking at us.
It is completely white.
Oh, it's blind, maybe.
Give me a nature check.
Oh, absolutely.
Ah. Of course, you'd have a blind beholder as a sentry.
That makes sense to me. Nature check, so that is intelligence. Wonderful. Ooh. Oh, sorry, I should roll in there.
Yep.
There! That's where we roll in the box.
Nice.
Oh, next one.
25.
Dropping those
you know, twos. It is an undead beholder.
Oh!
No shit.
Because of that is non-sentience and cannot communicate. But it is being controlled in some manner.
Oh, very good. I think it's a it's a non-sentient beholder, and it cannot communicate. But it must be being controlled in some way. This might be the perfect chance for Rupert.
Who's Rupert?
I say, summoning from my extra-dimensional pouch my familiar. Mm-hmm. And you guys see, it looks like a large white newt, maybe 3 feet long.
Oh my god! And he's so cute.
It has just—he's got little pinprick eyes and like a little like sleepy smile for a mouth, and pink frilled kind of gills coming off. Yes, Rupert the Axolotl.
You see,
yes, you see, he's a wonderful creature. They engage in parthogenesis, which is a phenomenal capability where they don't evolve to their fully. They don't. Transmute into their fully developed form until after certain environmental changes. And he goes on like that for a bit.
As he's talking, can I kick another bar off?
Sure.
And then I want to.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
So one.
No, that was a eight.
Four.
And a four.
Okay.
Eight.
Okay. You hit it. Nothing happens.
So I want to try and send Rupert out, if I can, to skitter out along the edges over to the chest.
Sure. Do you have a token for
leverage
Rupert's?
That open? Oh,
If not here, we got
there bottle, you go.
This bottle cap.
Bottle cap for Rupert?
Yeah, he's, I guess, smaller than that. But
the New Belgium bike.
Maybe my D4 that works.
D4 would be perfect.
Okay, there we go.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to try and send him. Stick against the wall, Rupert! The frog pills, you must find them!
Is he literally sticking to the wall?
Oh,
yeah, he's new, right?
Yes, he is. He's going to try and skitter and stick up in the murky shadows.
Okay, give me a perception check, or give me a stealth check.
Ooh, good.
Do you need to dump water on him for him to survive?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Wait, but I didn't roll in the right fucking spot.
It was a 20.
I will give that to you, but still.
It's a 2.
Keep it in the box.
Okay. All right, sorry.
There's a 0 next to that 2.
Yeah, let me put that 0. Yeah. So if that was a 20, that would be a 22.
Okay. Well,
if it was 20, a 20,
it's a crit. So sneaks past. No one's able to see him. The sentry makes no movements. He gets to the box, and the lid is locked.
Mm-hmm.
It's heavy. It's weighted down. What does he do?
I suppose.
Tell him to use the end of his tail. It's really pokey. Have him try and you know, pick the lock.
To leverage the lock off.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Rupert.
Oh, yeah.
Leverage the lock off.
Give me a lock pick check. Disadvantage, because you're using your tail.
Oh, I need a second d20. Yes,
absolutely. What a clever creature.
Rupert's incredibly clever. Did I tell you about pathogenesis yet?
While he's doing that, yeah, we'd like to kick the bar again.
Okay.
You are so strong.
In the box.
Okay, ignore that one. There we go.
That was 12.
It's 12.
Ooh, looks
and
like
I'm
a 2.
Oh, no, disadvantage. Oh, fuck.
Okay. 2. So 4 total.
Jams his tail in there, and you see him wiggling around, and it gets caught.
Good job, Rupert. Oh, shit. Oh, no.
I have a sprite familiar.
So you kick the bar.
I'm
going to
send my sprite familiar to help
it lets out a long,
all familiars.
Loud
oh
bang.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
That's all.
Okay, so I'm
going
to send
my
sprite.
I have that other bar, right?
Oh, yeah.
So did we have to get a donation to the like the saving throw page, or since I got a donation, can that count towards?
That can count towards it, right?
All
right.
Mm-hmm. So
do we want to try and
towards
for
what?
Donations towards the in-game things that are happening now? Do we have them go to the saving throw page, or can they donate to the individual person?
It's easier if it will work either way, but it's easier if they send it to the saving throw.
Okay.
Oh, I have this.
Just because I can keep track of it.
Yes.
By the way. You are eating candy out of someone's mouth.
Yeah, as soon as I said $20, I was like, that's so stupid.
Oh my god, yeah.
Oh, for another like 20, maybe they can choose who it comes from.
I don't think I want to choose. I think it's better if I don't.
Yeah.
Just, I don't want to be
involved.
Someone
just hands it to you over
I
your shoulder,
like
you don't see
we should all do a little bit.
Just
all
no.
You just pelt him once, yes. Like he has his mouth open, we spit it into his mouth.
Oh, well, spitting into my mouth is just a fetish that I have.
I feel like it happened because Erica was doing it.
Don't wait till my character eats candy again. Because you can't just like get candy out of nowhere, so my character has to
right,
candy
yeah, that's
again.
Crazy. That's insane.
I've candy never seen
I feel like we
Sean
should do this
blush.
As soon as possible.
Yeah, I'm not super no. happy about the situation in general, but I get that I put myself
yeah,
into it.
Yeah, you made it so, super like, cheap.
Yeah,
so let's do it right now.
$20 is now.
Yeah, I think she's right.
Let's get it out of the way. This way we can move
okay.
on to...
You guys, I'm hungry. I'm so hungry.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God.
Are we recording this? No. Into your mouth.
Oh no!
Yeah.
Wait, does he have to like lay
baby
down?
Oh god!
Oh,
god.
Oh, baby bird!
Oh god!
Hold on!
Don't make her choke.
Oh, my god.
Oh boy!
All right, open up! Oh my god, y'all!
Oh god!
This
oh
is...
my god!
No. I really, I'm so sorry.
Oh!
Yeah!
All them levels down.
Oh my fucking god! Like all oh in your beard
no,
too,
yeah.
and
yeah.
like it. Yeah. Oh god, y'all!
Saving throw, saving throw,
oh, saving throw,
throw, saving throw,
throw, saving throw.
Oh.
I know.
I'm just gonna keep watching this throughout the rest of the game.
Oh god, y'all! Oh my god.
Yeah.
Shit. It's gonna be my new text. It's Amy screaming
it's
as I hear M&M's toppling into
God.
Mouth.
I will say they taste exactly like regular peanut M&M's.
Yeah. Only they're like
they're
already
flavored.
Kind of
they're ishi.
It's actually it's convenience wise I get
spice.
It. Like I get why birds
spicy.
Do the thing that they do. It makes a lot of sense.
Less work for you.
It's a lot less work for me.
Oh my god.
Not as
my god.
You know what? Honestly, like this is one additional reason why Garbage Chat is Garbage Chat. Like
they would do this.
They're just yeah. interested in the simplest, most disgusting things.
Yes.
It's like, oh, I can
my kind of
listen,
people.
You guys
right,
can
yeah, yeah.
send me bad
I could,
guys to take
I house. Could make an intellectual joke, but it would be lost on them. So instead, I'm going to make a fart sound, and that's going to be at the top of their intelligence.
Great.
Well, go ahead, where is it?
There you go.
So,
all right,
his tail's caught.
Oh, Tam. Tam,
yes.
Real quick. So there's a sprite. Next to me. And by the way, I'm pink with white hair. Like that's
of
what
course.
I look like. And my sprite is kind of emulating that. And she's actually like the demon that I communicate with, who gives me all my lore and knowledge. And I'm like, oh, Tam, real quick, just go and like help out that little newt. Go help him out and get him unstuck because he seems like a delightful creature. And so she's going to turn herself invisible and head on over there.
Okay.
Your warlock is delightful.
Yeah. Oh, she's just... Oh,
she's okay.
The nicest little thing.
She's okay.
Erica, yes.
So I am finding my voluminous giant hair, like a hairpin, like hidden. I was like, how long has that been in there? Anyway, can I?
Owl flies
up. Whoa! Oh, good.
The barn owl, native to the area.
I hope it doesn't have a nest in there. And I pull it out and start working on the manacles.
Okay, give me a lockpick check.
Okay,
nice.
Is that sleight of hand?
Sleight of hand.
Side note: you have wet M&M on here.
It's like a soda Sean in her.
Right next to your necklace.
Sean, get it for her.
On the chest. On your chest.
You can't see it because it's real
put
high
your
up.
Head back.
It's on your skin.
I'm yeah, very sorry, oh, but God. It's right that there.
He's using
thank
thumb.
You.
Got it. Yeah. For the record, I wasn't
okay.
It's chest.
19 plus 28.
Yeah.
28.
The manacle comes free.
Yes.
Nice.
You are now unchained.
All of us?
Just her.
All right.
Well,
but I think it's fair to assume that she can continue to.
Right. I'm gonna. Can I take a 10 and then take a 10 and then take everybody get everybody else's off?
I'm not taking 10 because there's things happening outside that may. Normally, taking 10, you've got as much time as you need.
Right.
With this, things are happening. So.
Does Taz need to make a light lockpick check to unlock the noose?
To unlock the tail.
We'll get to that 1 second, Basura. What are you doing?
Excellent.
Basurero is going to also attempt to kick a bar with disadvantage.
Okay.
Basurero is relatively strong. That's the thing. The thing about garbage people that you don't know is that what they lack in brains, which is a lot,
oh.
They're so dumb, but they do have a decent amount of strength.
Okay.
And they succeeded exactly to the extent that garbage people normally do in the real world, which is that I rolled a natural one.
He botched.
Yeah.
You botched it.
Yeah.
He botched.
All right. Your foot goes through the bar.
Mm-hmm.
It is now caught. You're mm-hmm. going to take...
Oh, Garthok, no one can
2 points of damage.
Take a bar okay. the way you do.
And you're now stuck, so you're yeah, unable to move.
Oh my god. But look at him
two
try.
Damage?
Two damage.
Okay.
How big are garbage people's feet? That it gets stuck between the bars.
It's not the size, which is abnormally large. It's the disgusting nature of their
when
feet.
When he says stuck, the bars are this far apart. Yeah. The foot goes through, turns, and it's like, I can't get
yeah.
up.
And to be honest, I tried everything I could think of. And like my foot again. Just will not come through the bars, and so I'm out of ideas.
So your wisdom is real low.
My wisdom isn't very low. My intelligence isn't 8. I'm just... I am exactly as smart as you would expect a garbage person to be. I'm actually, at an 8 intelligence, I'm a paragon of intelligence of the garbage people. An 8 is very high for a garbage yeah. person okay. In intelligence.
That's why I fight for the garbage people.
Yeah.
garbage people.
All right, Amy, what were you saying about the lockpicking tail?
Well, I just think Tess
you gonna try and work it out?
Yeah, let's give her some dex, right?
Okay, just give me a straight dex roll.
Okay.
Yeah, X level.
Oh, 23.
You have one.
23. Tail comes out, no problem.
Great.
Oh, I freed him. Oh, I freed. You're a newt. You're axolotl.
Axolotl. Erica that's, owns an wait, axolotl.
Is that the way Taz sounds?
That's Taz. Yeah.
That can't be true. Yeah. Really?
This is what he looks like.
She actually owns one in real life.
Oh.
I did not know that.
Might have to brighten it.
Oh, my God.
No, that's actually Erica's Patronus.
Yeah, it was. That's right.
Okay, let me
my fucking Patronus.
What was it? The water bear?
Like the
water bear?
The water bear's the little tiny microscopic
the tiny, things.
Tardigrades.
Tardigrades.
Oh, nice.
That's the other thing that we were looking at the other day.
Oh. Wow.
Yay,
and
science.
This has been Biology Corner. Thank you.
Now I saw that my garbage person got his stupid foot stuck. I'm going to leverage him out.
Okay.
I'm going to try to figure out how to get him.
Give me a strength saving throw. Pull him out.
So Kerfuffle has the ability to spend 10 minutes to turn a cubic foot.
Oh,
I don't
know if
that
happens.
It's a 2.
What did you try?
Your arm gets jammed in there with the two garbage people just stuck in the
bar. I'm not a garbage person. I just fight for them.
I immediately jam myself into the bar with his.
Oh,
arm.
They're stuck too.
All right.
Three of your don't friends are now stuck
dungeon,
in bars.
The dead.
So I have.
We're all just stuck here.
That beholder's here.
The bars are so, here.
I could have had the room empty.
Hold on. So we're like, which one are you? Are you?
I'm in? This one.
I'm
this
the baby.
One. So you're the baby. This one.
Yep.
So we're all just jammed.
This is the rogue. Yeah, and the other baby.
Okay. Hey, we defeated the beholder!
Oh, oh no, I'll get it going here.
So we have a little Three Stooges accent going on right now.
Ah, okay, very good. Just hold still for one moment. I can, well, for 10 minutes,
no,
just hold
what?
Still.
Real quick, remove him first.
Wazwomnia. No, instead, I grab the bars and I'm going to start. There's no problem that can't be solved through transmutation. Here we go. So I grab the metal bars.
Turn the bar into?
I can change the, assuming these are iron. Bars, I can change them into...
Bugs!
Well,
no.
Wait, bugs! What a use of power.
Bugs?
I'm going to turn these bars into nice, moldable, solid silver. That should be... That's fairly bendable, right?
So a lot more bendable than iron.
Right, yeah. We could just bend that pretty easily, and we'll have a lot of silver. Okay, cool. Here we are. Okay, just hang tight.
I feel like this isn't going to turn out.
How many cubic feet would you say these bars take up?
That takes me. Maybe just two of them? Or
are you doing two bars or just one bar?
Well, how many?
Are we all
what's
stuck
the minimum
in one
number
space?
To get them? Yeah, whatever
just
the
one bar.
We
you guys
all
are all stuck in
one
space.
Bar?
Yeah. If I think I can get them out with one bar, I'm just concentrating on one bar. It takes me 10 minutes per cubic foot of material.
It's like one cubic foot for one bar.
Yeah, it's like 6 feet tall.
Great. Okay, just hang tight for no more than an hour.
Erica, give me an intelligence saving throw.
Take your time. I've never gotten an up close look at your arm like this before. My goodness, is it brawny?
16. You realize these bars are very breakable as is, and with a decent strength check, you can shatter them.
Oh, please do that.
It's just people have been.
Well, I'm not very strong. How far apart are they?
Okay, I'm gonna headbutt.
They're about a foot apart between each one.
Oh, well.
Is my head
I probably actually squeeze through them.
Probably. Is
all
my
right,
head close
I'm gonna try
to
yeah, do that.
Yeah. My head's not important.
I'm gonna headbutt.
Are you both gonna headbutt the same bar?
Yeah, we're gonna both headbutt the same bar at the same time.
Okay.
God damn it.
I'm going to spend.
Mine is a 15.
I'm thinking about spending a luck point, but I feel like you're gonna break the bar with your.
Yeah, but what is yours is.
Mine's gonna be a total of 7, so I should probably spend the luck point to make sure I don't mess up your chance at it. Okay, yeah, so, whatever the fuck.
Okay, so you guys are 20 garbage person skills.
I'm not a garbage person!
You sure fight for the garbage people!
You're an honorary garbage person.
You are an honorary garbage person.
You're everything
your
you
headbuds come together in one mighty strike. And the bar shatters.
If you want to become a garbage person, I have a special initiation that I can
through the
bring
bars,
you
no
into.
Problem.
All right, so I'm gonna.
Now outside of it,
that
in
was
the same
over
room
too,
as the
that
beholder.
Was over
so I'd like to sneak over, sneak past the beholder to the chest, shoulder. And I since I'm a supreme sneak, I get advantage on stealth if I move half speed.
Good. Go ahead and move.
Remember when we were trapped in a bar together?
Yeah, it was great.
I feel like that's a good opening for a joke. Two amazingly attractive people go into a bar.
Do I have a silent spell?
No.
Yeah,
right next to the beholder,
no,
right?
No.
Right here.
Right out of the corner, yeah. Do you want to roll stealth?
Yeah, give me stealth check.
No.
Oh no.
Oh no.
No.
18.
18?
Yeah, it's actually not bad.
No, that's not bad.
It's not bad.
But the beholder is watching this area. Its eyes pop up and it turns towards you, and you see one of its eye stalks begin to illuminate. Blue. It fires off a ray towards you.
Oh no!
Does a 21 hit you?
What color is the beam?
It is blue.
Okay.
Oh dear God, no! The bar it fell down.
It's broken. Yes.
Your transmutation.
It's lost.
If only you could have waited. 15 more minutes.
Give me a dexterity saving throw.
Okay.
I may kill you right now.
Oh, God.
I'm sorry.
Wait.
No,
what?
Way. No way.
No, the blue beam is not the worst.
You're not metagaming, right?
23.
My character knows this.
Yeah.
23.
The garbage people know.
I need a lot more d8s.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Fuck y'all.
Can I have some more
d8s? It's still not the worst. I'm proud.
I've got d8s
okay,
here.
Great.
I didn't know there was different colored beams that did different. I know that they have different beams. I know they're different colored.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Oh, Penelope.
I mean, this is going to hurt for sure.
Just, nine.
Yeah.
Can I, if we are in combat, can I use a reaction to take half damage?
You are taking half damage.
Okay.
So you succeeded. Huzzah.
So take 20, no, half of that. You're going to take 11 points of damage.
Okay.
That's halved and then halved again.
Mm-hmm. Oh, 11. So halved and halved is going to be, we'll say, 5 points of damage. I'll round down for you.
Ooh.
I didn't know whose was who, so I'm just throwing them all out there. You guys can pick them out.
Oh.
And that other green one's probably mine.
None of those are mine.
So you take 5 points of damage, and it is a ray of disintegration. The stone behind you just disappears.
Oh, cool. Disintegration spell!
Oh.
You're now an initiative. Give me your initiative checks.
Yeah.
The transmutation. That's a transmutation spell. Oh, jeez.
It is. Very good one.
Don't shout him out. I'll come around and get him from you guys.
You'll come around?
Yes, I will come around. Ooh, verbally. Okay. I'll verbally come around, Amy.
Oh, good.
I wish you would just come around.
18.
I wish you'd just come.
I don't.
That's so early.
I can help with that.
Ah. I don't.
This is going to turn into one sexy stream, I think. I like it already.
If you're interested, I have a few skills that I've learned over the years.
Okay.
It's all sloppy and garbage skills.
Gross. I'll charge you nothing for it.
I would stay away from him. I hear the STDs.
I will charge you nothing for it.
I don't charge.
I know you don't.
There's one person in this room I will not charge anything for anything.
Who?
Garthok.
It's Garthok.
Yeah.
Garbage stock.
Garbage stock.
Garbage stock. So, does anyone have 25 to 20?
No.
No. 20 to 15?
Mm-hmm. Yes. 18.
18.
Oh, actually, yes, 17.
God damn it, people.
You said 20 first, so I assumed it was above 20. I wasn't listening. I just listened to the first number.
His fault.
Yeah, 17. My bad.
Yeah, 20 to 15. Sorry, what is that? You go lower scores? Than higher. Fucking 10. Terrible.
10. 13.
Okay, Garthog, Basuero.
You're so mad.
All right, 15 to 10.
My character is a real piece of shit.
15 to 10.
Me, 14.
Okay.
Yeah, you're right. When you say top to bottom, you don't register it right away.
Yeah, I just hear 20. I'm like, oh, okay, I don't need to listen to him.
No, 20. And then what did you get, sir?
Three.
All right.
The bar, the beautiful
three.
Bar.
Three.
I'll be with you in a minute.
Isn't I this? Love just how joyful.
Can you get, yeah. can you get that chunk open, please? I need my babies. I need
Wait, what is happening?
I need my dread sisters.
What is this
talking
mean?
About me?
All right, Penelope, you're first.
Okay.
Who's talking?
So I can use as a reaction. I'm going to try and pick the lock on the thing on the chest with my hairpin.
Oh, be careful about the axolotl.
Real quick, Amy, you have $100 in Barky Bucks to spend as she sees fits.
All right.
That is to Sean's favorite guy, Space Colonizer.
Yes, space colonizer.
Yeah, for the children.
For the children. In space.
How many?
Colonize space. Destroy space.
Make him eat.
It's so many inside jokes right now.
Right. Yeah. $20 is going to make him eat M&Ms out of Erica's mouth
again.
Yeah!
Rule of three. We got to do it once more on top of that.
Right.
I'll be ready with the slow motion comedy. This time.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And then I want to buy rerolls for everybody except you.
Why?
So how many rerolls would that be? How many rerolls would I get for $80?
$3 a piece.
$3 a piece?
I'm just going to let the stream know now that we're going to cap that M&M thing at 3.
Yeah,
because
that's fine.
The comedy
rule
of 3, I think 3 is just fine.
Sounds like a quitter. That's like quitter's mentality.
Does anyone need anything else for their characters that I can decide for them with my $100?
So work with Dom. You guys can figure out what you're going to spend it on. Let me know.
Okay.
And then we'll pass it all out. This is what we have. We got campaign coins and whatnot in there. We can do for rerolls.
I'm going
to also cap
coins.
The rerolls for people at 10.
Okay.
No more than 10. I think that's fair. So.
Yeah, but it caps at you at 10 for you as well.
Well, I have to take on all five of you, so I should be like
no,
50.
That's not fair. Yeah. I do not agree with that.
I mean,
it caps at 10 for
you get
all
the five
of us.
And you divide by the. It's good. It's worth.
Thank you, Space Colonizer.
Yes, thank you, Space Colonizer. You're a gem.
Awesome. Bucks?
Ooh, they're like as if the chat is paying, but then we get to spend them. So,
essentially, it's like store credit.
Yeah. So instead of like buying the things normally, they're just like do what you want with this money.
Cool.
Yeah.
Who else needs a catchphrase?
I don't have a catchphrase.
I do.
How much was yours?
Mine was like.
You should have a catchphrase. Melting your mouth and not your hand. Though.
Yours is
50?
Yeah.
Might be worth it. How much is yours?
I did not include that as an option, so you could probably just do it.
$5.
I'm a cheap $5. So $5.
Yeah. Oh, mother. Okay.
His catchphrase should be, put it in my mouth.
Put it in my mouth!
Yeah, that's a good one.
I can't deny that.
That's not a big deal.
Yeah.
Your catchphrase.
Put it
in
my mouth.
And this is not a battle cry. This is a catchphrase. Yeah. You use it as often as Barky uses the word family.
Okay, I can, yeah. That's a lot, by the way. For people who don't watch Barky's Brigade, that is a lot. And I will make sure to, I can handle that.
You can handle it in your mouth?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I have a very stretchable mouth.
Yeah.
Like most garbage people.
Like most garbage people, I can handle anything.
They put a lot in their mouth. And they don't chew it all, but they will try and swallow it.
One curmudgeon of a hoopla.
One curmudgeon of a hoopla.
And that's your that's like your joyful way of saying, well, boy, are we in a fix.
Excellent.
Use the catchphrase to explain another catchphrase.
And put it in my and to be clear, put it in my mouth means I'm using it as punctuation, basically. Okay, good. Just wanted to make sure.
Okay, good. Put it in my mouth.
Okay, yeah. Good, good, good. Just wanted to make sure I understood. Put it in my mouth.
Okay, so now I have. Oh my god! Like I'm the worst.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
I'm like this
literal worst.
Dumb yeah. techno.
If you were any more of a hot mess, you would be a garbage person. Yeah.
So you go ahead and you're gonna pick the lock, correct?
Yes.
Okay. As a what is a bonus action you said?
Yeah, it's one of my reactions.
Okay.
Yes. Oh nice.
Ooh, that doesn't look good. That's a 12.
Mm. 12 will not do it.
Wait, but
start working.
Yeah. The axolotl and I think Tam are both helping her. Can she get advantage on that?
I will go ahead and allow that. I'll say some advantage.
Awesome.
You've already rolled one die, so we'll just roll one more.
Rupert!
The invisible.
That's
hard technically better. Not,
yeah, that's 15.
15. Here, plink. Give me a dexterity saving throw.
We did
saving throw?
Oh, yes. No.
Oh, no. Rupert. Okay.
What? Who would put traps in a dungeon? Those guys.
That's a 9. So that would be. Oh, thank you.
These are rerolls.
That is an 18.
Sausage.
Do I get rerolls?
18. No. The dart
I
flies
only have
past
eight.
Your head.
Wait,
you're so very lucky.
I grabbed them so that I have them.
That was almost one curmudgeon of a hoopla.
There
because
we go.
I don't like the most of those. I don't like.
Okay.
These are the ones that I like.
So okay. I bought rerolls, two rerolls for everybody except for the garbage person.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because I feel like that's how Space Colonizer would want it.
Right. No. I mean, to me, it would be offensive if garbage people were given any opportunity in life. Like, let's just let them figure it out on their own. Hey, Garbagette, pull yourself up by your bootstraps, all right? It's not up to us to help you out, okay?
And yet, haven't I?
Yeah.
All right.
All right, I'm going to use my action to gear up.
Okay.
And grab everything in the chest.
Okay, do you grab everything or do you gear up? So it's going to be two separate things.
I'm just going to grab everything.
Okay, you just
grab everything.
Okay.
And start moving back.
Okay, I'm going to say since you had to bend over and grab everything, you're going to be moving at half speed.
Yes, and I'm going to move at half speed anyway so I get advantage on stealth.
Ooh.
You have been spotted, so you're no longer stealth.
All right.
The beholder That's fine, and then. All of its many eyes.
Yep. Mm.
All right. So if there's any way to move back towards everybody else.
Like that?
Yes.
There we go.
Oh,
perfect.
Boy.
Garthok. What are you doing, sir?
I'm for my first action.
For the garbage people.
I'd like to.
Sean, what would you like for pizza? We got sausage, pepperoni, or veggie.
Veggie, because I do
That's
not
right,
eat meat. Yeah, yeah. It's you know, it's not a big
What's that?
It's not
Is
a big deal.
Pizza?
I just don't eat. Yes. I don't eat meat.
We're gonna have the guys get it for you.
Oh.
What would you like?
I want
What are you doing, sir?
Mushrooms and olives.
Okay.
Or just cheese.
Not sure that's available.
Okay.
It's the pizza's already here.
They're gonna grab it from the table.
I didn't see the pizza boxes either.
This is what I'd like to do. Yeah. I want to go up to Penelope.
Okay.
Grab my dread sisters.
Okay.
My two battle axes.
Ooh.
All right. I'm gonna say,
that's a cool name for your axe.
That is it. You're gonna have to spend 5 feet to get through the bars.
Okay, so 5 feet.
Okay. Well, that's gonna be 10 feet.
10, 15, 20, 25.
Perfect. You're there.
I will grab, and then I will take my dread sisters and whip them around. Just
thank you.
Holder. Yep. Thank you.
You're welcome.
For the garbage people.
For the garbage people. Put it in my mouth.
God damn it.
Okay, sir.
So I just roll 1d20, 2d20.
So you're doing your first attack, so it's you have multiple attack, and you have dual wielding.
Yes.
So you have like 6 attacks.
Sweet. So for my first...
Well, actually, you're gonna have like 4 attacks.
Yeah.
Yes!
Right. So 18, 22.
Hits.
The first one. Do you want me, should I roll all my attacks?
Roll all your attacks, and we'll get the damage after.
Uh-huh. Ooh.
That's gonna miss.
That's a 7.
Still gonna miss.
All right. Nice.
Pretty
17,
good.
21.
Okay.
I'm just gonna roll this die.
Again.
22.
Okay, that's 4. That's done.
It's 4?
Yeah, you did 4 attacks.
Yeah, you said 6.
Yeah, I missed.
He was wrong.
4. All right, so 3.
He was real wrong.
I was wrong, but I corrected very quickly.
3 hit.
3 hits? Okay, give me the damage.
Wow, that's gonna be.
You should have like 3d8s, I believe, plus 15.
Nice!
Yeah.
Yes.
Pretty
yes.
Great. Oh, Garth.
Standard attack.
2.
Do you want all the. Do you want some more d8s?
Nah.
Not from you.
9. 16 plus 15.
It's gonna be 31.
31 damage.
Nice, nice. Hits.
How much would it be if someone like slapped you across the face?
It's gonna be more than $20.
Yeah.
Would it be more than $20?
Yeah. Like $25 probably.
Too, right?
I mean, for sure, like.
Because Amy's trained, is what I'm saying. She could really do some
damage. But Amy.
She does Muay Thai.
Well, but the difference is Amy. Here's the thing. Amy has known me for long enough that there's a bit of her that's gonna feel bad about it. Like, David, although, you know. Like, he doesn't know me, so I'd be real concerned about how hard
you actually, I think you would prefer to have David slap because he's got a bigger hand. It's wider, so it's going to be flatter. It's going to spread the damage over
a wider
area.
Yeah, that makes sense. I think you'd much rather
absolutely
have me slap you than Amy, though.
Yeah, absolutely.
Amy, though, it's
going to
be more concentrated.
Yeah,
I feel like there's a woman's
sense, he's
going to
hit harder.
For, like, slapping.
Yeah.
Like, where you're just, like, you just know where.
Catch the cheek just right.
I think you're not a bad person. So I think you're not trying to hurt me. Whereas David's like, I've known this guy for all of a fucking hour.
He's been insulting chat since
guy.
He's
just
like
hammered
the
me.
The thing is, I've already spent everything else. So it has to be $20.
Oh, boy.
No. People can add on to that.
So well, I just
how much to take
$5?
Your shirt off?
That's nothing. I don't know. All
right.
I mean,
do it.
Yeah. I have an undershirt.
We can't do that on Twitch anymore.
Yeah, you're actually, I did research that. You can't take your shirt. And honestly, like, it's not
that
good
is
for anybody. Yeah.
So, real okay. quick.
Let's
Sean,
just let's just get
what
back
are you
to.
What are you doing?
Yeah.
Thank you.
I don't want to get slapped.
So how did that look? How did my cool ass.
Your two axes come around and just. You attack it.
Do I cut off any of his eye stalks?
You do not cut off any of his eye stalks, but you chop into him.
I'll do.
No, you're not a precision fighter. You're just a hit 'em a lot guy.
It's not like I'm not a sushi chef. I work at freaking Starbucks.
You're perfect.
Would you tell us if the beholder looked bloodied?
I would
not?
Tell you if we're gonna use fourth edition lingo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he does.
Does not.
Does not. Oh, okay.
Okay. So I Bossarero. Comes charging in at the beholder, you taking the extra 5 feet movement for the bars that you mentioned, and I attack the beholder.
Okay, with what?
With I don't have a fucking weapon yet. All right, well then I'm gonna cast a spell.
oh wait, magic. I'll allow you if you want. You can pick up that rusted bar that Garthok kicked out, and you can use that as a weapon. Thank you, sir.
I don't think it's going to do much damage is the thing.
Okay.
I'm going to use my action to cast Bless, which from a garbage person's standpoint, means I'm gonna just take a good look at each person, maintain eye contact, and say, "You're better than me. You're better than me. You're better than me. I'm garbage."
And then you punctuate it with,
"Put it in my mouth." So anytime you make an attack roll or a saving throw this combat, you can add 1d4 as well to that d20 roll.
Nice.
To attack or damage?
To the d20 roll on the attack roll or saving throw. Mm. So just to those types of d20 rolls. Great. So just roll an extra d4 whenever you make an attack or a saving throw.
Okay.
And add that.
Good, good, good.
All right. Lina.
Linnea?
Linnea. Yeah.
Okay.
Hawaii.
So my cantrips, I can cast those without my orb?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cantrips. Then, yeah, Eldritch Blast, motherfucker. I am going to move, though. I'm going to try to get to the chest so I can make a...
A d20?
Chest is empty.
On yeah,
chest is empty. It's all in
saving throw. Add that to it.
Oh, it's it. Okay, great. So
you
I'm...
Just add it.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess I don't need to move. I'll just get out of the bars. And Eldritch Blast, and I've got 3.
Do you have to have line of sight?
You can shoot through fronds.
Okay, cool.
All right, and I get to add my charisma damage to each pull.
She's so pretty.
Okay, 10 plus. That's
you got to first roll to see if you hit.
Oh, I do. Oh.
Jumping the gun a little bit.
Okay, great.
A wee bit.
Yeah, good.
We're
call.
Being optimistic here.
Listen, we're rolling stop, Mason. So, fucking slow your roll and just watch her hit real quick, and let's move on.
That's right.
Stop is just gonna nail the hit, and we're gonna be fine.
Does a 19 hit?
Mm-hmm. A 19 does hit.
Of course, great. It does,
okay,
like always.
So 10, 12, plus 12 is 24.
24?
Yes.
What's your dexterity?
I get to add my charisma
so,
mod.
Yeah, plus 5. And then
to damage.
You're a low.
And those. Are, so you're saying that stop and go are up for grabs today?
Stop. Both stop and go, my trusty weapons. Every warrior needs to name his or her choice of weapons, and these are mine.
Why would you guys do that?
And stop and go are together as a set, because don't you dare separate them.
$500 for the both?
$500 to have me mail them to you, and they already have a bond with me.
So you're gonna take like an action to attune them, right? It's a full day.
I think there are situations where you would want to kind of like split them up. Like imagine like, okay, let's say you have children that you want to give up for adoption. One of them is clearly better than the other. Jeez. So, like, let's just keep one and have the other up for adoption. Like, twins are an example where you could split them
this
up.
This is a really good example of don't listen to anything Sean says.
Exactly. unfortunately, Bespikar, he loves you, Sean. You get 3 free rerolls. Enjoy that.
Ooh. Yeah, fuck garbage people.
He felt bad that everyone else got 2. You got none.
Yeah.
Well played, Amy.
That's true. He did feel bad for me. You should always feel bad for garbage people because they have had the worst things happen to them in their life.
Now, here's the thing.
Deservedly so. They deserve that shame and all the bad things that happen to them.
I'd like for this campaign not to leave this room.
And
we're just going to spend
just between us and 800 people who are watching.
Yeah. No. I mean, like, our party never leaves this room.
There is actually, I think there's a phrase, what happens in prison stays in prison.
I'm changing
put it in your mouth,
$20.
Put it in your mouth.
From the eating M&Ms.
Oh.
And I'm changing it to actually.
Garthok does an 11.
Erica
hits.
Has to hug Sean.
Oh, that would be that to her.
Nice. No, yeah.
Seriously.
I want to slow motion that M&M thing.
No.
The M&M thing.
We'll let the people decide.
All right, you know what?
M&M thing or Erica hug Sean?
For $50, I will eat pizza from another person's mouth.
Whoa.
Just. Yeah.
Really?
All right.
You're really living up to the garbage person like
standards.
Even one with meat?
I want to point out no, it has to be vegetarian.
Oh, okay.
But I just want to point out that this character has lived in dumpsters. The idea of eating food out of another person's mouth is nothing to this character. This character has literally eaten cardboard for breakfast.
This is
so this is nothing. Mm-hmm. All
right, so the beholder, I know, right, shoots out an eye ray at Garthok, looking to take him out. It misses. Garthok dodges out of the way, deftly. Now it's
you know,
time to
gnome, fight garbage through. People gnomes.
Oh, kerfuffle.
Another one
kerfuffle.
Of those things.
But kerfuffle. So the very first thing I would do, I guess, would be rush over to you. That's 5 feet of movement to get through there. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. That gets me adjacent. Great.
Frog pills, I say. Get that out of my face! Hit them all to the ground and start going through
the cameras. I wish the cameras could see the face that Erica just made with
me.
She looked kind of like a frog herself.
Had frog aspects.
So I probably knock the stuff to the ground and just start sorting through. Going, pills, come on, my pills? Where are they? I don't know. Investigation check to find my small little bag of pills, or maybe I find them automatically. I don't know. But I'm pretty good at investigation. 16.
You find your pills.
Okay. And then I start putting them into my mouth. Okay. Yes, that's fine. That's fine.
You're good.
So it's movement, and then I'm going to, or probably my action as well. Anyway, I'm also going to have Rupert. Rupert, back to me. I think that's it for my turn.
Okay. And at that, we are going to take a short break, 5 minutes, and then we'll come right back. Folks, thank you for tuning in to another episode of Saving Throw Live. This is going to be our first episode of an actual campaign. No more one-shots.
Yay, thank God.